Good evening, everybody. So, problem is my answer. I will talk English, okay, and maybe Manu will translate me. Thank you very much for Maria, Maxine, and to Yoga Vidya that invite me to come and to talk a little bit, to explain a little bit about my experience and to transfer it to you. Maybe I ask first, how many of you never hear, or let's say you don't have much experience or knowledge about what is Vipassana, about Buddhism, about the connections between Vipassana and Buddhism? So what I do today, I start from beginning. Okay, I explain first. Try to build the basic things for Vipassana, for what we call Buddhism, and the connection between them. Okay, and then I teach you some technique of meditation, and we can practice together. And after this, if anyone have any questions, you're most welcome. So for explaining this, maybe I will start from, let's say, I will tell you something connect to the history. Okay, maybe this kind of story that I'm going to tell, some of you already know. This story is about the prince. He was living 2,500 years ago in India. Yeah. And he was living 29 years inside the palace. He was living in the good times, good conditions of the palace, with good food, good friends, games, everything very, very nicely. And then when he reached 29 years, already he get married and he have little baby. And when he reached 29 years, this is the first time when he start to go out of the palace and to look for the world out of the palace. And then he start to see that sometimes people get sick, sometimes people get old, sometimes people die. He start to see that in the life there is also difficulties and problems, what we call suffering. And then he start to ask himself, he have any technique or any ways or any let's say tools in the life to overcome this suffering? And then he decided to go out from the palace and to look for teachers that teach him how to overcome the suffering. And then he, when he left the palace, he tried to look for different teachers. He go like this 6 years. 6 years he was traveling between different teachers till he come to be 35 years. And then he decided, when he see that he cannot find any teacher, he decided to leave the teachers to go to look by himself. And then one evening he was sitting and start to make different exercise on himself. And in the morning he find out what he wants. What he find out is something very, very simple, very easy. What he find out is the important to be in the present moment, to live here and now. He find out that if people, they are driving, and they concentrate and they be mindful about the driving, the possible that they make accident is less. He find out that if people, they are, listen, if someone want to cut the vegetables, and he move the knife and he pay attention how he cut the vegetables, if he concentrate, if he be mindful about the way that he cut the vegetable, the possible that he cut his finger is less. He find out that if people that are talking to the friend, they be mindful, they pay attention how they talk to the friend, the possible that they speak something foolish, they hurt the friend, they speak wrongly, it's less. He find out that if people, they pay attention how they are thinking, how they are speaking, how they are acting, they speak better, they think better, they act better, they be better people for themselves and for others. And like this, in the night, he start to look at himself. He start to see, I have a pain. He look at the pain. He start to hear something. He see maybe he afraid from the what he hear. He pay attention to it. And slowly, slowly, he can understand himself better. He could understand the life better. And in the morning, he what we call get enlightenment. He understood the life better. This man that I'm talking about, his name was Siddhartha. The family Gautama. Siddhartha Gautama, this is how they call it. Like I said, he was living 2,500 years ago in India, in north of India. He speaks the old ancient Indian language, what we call Pali. Maybe you know about the word of Sanskrit. Mostly people talking about Sanskrit. Sanskrit and Pali, they are two dialects. People talk at the same time, 2,500 years ago. Many books that you see here in Yoga Vidya, actually they are in Sanskrit. Because Sanskrit, the wise people, the educated people, they speak Sanskrit. The simple people, they speak Pali. Even he was a king actually, but he speaks to everybody. So that's why he used Pali. When we want to talk or to explain about the technique, what he find out, the teaching, we are using the same word. Hello, the same words or the same language that he used to speak. So most of the technical words we are using is in Pali. You know how they say understanding in Pali? Anyone know? Very simple. Buddha. And that's why the title they give him, it's not professor, not doctor, it's someone that understands Buddha. Sometimes people, they see the statue of the Buddha, they think, oh, he's a god, or he's a something, but he just was a human being. Actually, if we talk about this, nobody knows exactly how the Buddha looks like. In the books, he mentioned 32 elements of the body which the Buddha has. For example, here, the ear is big one, long neck, how do you say, crawl hair. So this is mentioned in the book. But it was no camera, no video to know how the Buddha actually looks. That's why when you look at different capture of the Buddha, different statue of the Buddha, you see different. But some of the things will be the same. But the people, they want to make something beautiful, because they like something like appreciate. So mostly when they make something beautiful, it looks like a woman. That's why many times you see the Buddha statue looks like a woman. And the technique that the Buddha find out, we see the other Gautama find out, they call it Vipassana. Vipassana actually is two words in Pali language. They connect it together. It's the word V and the word of Pasana. The meaning of the word V is into, through, direct, objectively, intuitively, from your own experience, not because you have to believe someone. The meaning of the word Pasana is to see. When we get them together, we see to see clear, to see through, to see into, this, to see by yourself. From your own understanding. And that's why we call it insight meditation. And the basic thing for the Vipassana is very simple. Just mindfulness. For example, if I ask you, what you are doing now? You are jumping, running, flying, what you are doing? Now, yes?
Sitting. Listening.
Let's talk about the sitting. This is already Vipassana. And so someone answers, you are very good Buddhist. Everybody has mindfulness, Even I asked the little boy, he play football, I asked, what you're doing? He said, I beat the ball. Because he pay attention, he know that he beat the ball. Everybody has mindfulness. But I ask you, how many times a day, maybe you put the MB somewhere you don't know where you put. Or maybe the key, you put the key somewhere you don't know where you put it. Sometimes people leave the house, they don't know, I closed the door, no, I didn't close the door. What about the gas? I turn off the gas or not? Happen to you this kind of thing sometimes?
Yes.
It's happened to anyone that he sometimes not forget, I did it or I didn't did it. Or I did not make it. Everybody. But you have mindfulness. So why no mindfulness? Because we have the mindfulness, everybody has mindfulness, but it's not developed. Mostly we all the time worry, what will be in the future? What I have to do tomorrow? What I have to do in the future? We worry about the future all the time. Or maybe I'm thinking about the past. Why I make this? This is the wrong thing. So I should not do this. Mind jumping to the past. The mind is jumping. Beep, 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 like a monkey. You see, like I say, everybody has mindfulness. It's not mean we don't have mindfulness, but it's not developed. It's just little bit weird. I give you an example of what it looks like. The same like what? Everybody have muscles, huh?
Yeah.
Muscles. Hmm? If I tell you, go and bring by yourself the refrigerator from one room to another room. Very difficult. Why? Because the muscles is not developed. So if we want to develop the muscles, what we have to do? We have to go to the gymnastic room, huh? And then we have to develop the muscles there. And then the man there, the trainer there, he will give us maybe 2 kilo. And he say, up, up. The culture, huh? We call it culture. Yeah. And then after one week, huh? You check and say, oh, now you can take 5 kilo. And then after some time you say, now we can go up to 10 kilo. And then continue maybe 100 kilo. Slap in there. Ah. But we have to do it slowly, slowly. And then we have strong muscles. But this is not magic. This is by developing. So in the same way, everybody has mindfulness.
Okay, now
it's not developed. So what we do in the course of the Vipassana, we are training on mindfulness, developing the mindfulness.
Yeah.
We start with very, very simple movement.
Yeah.
Because if I tell you, go shopping and be mindful, how can I start? Very difficult. So we have to start something simple. I cannot tell you go with it. Now if you want to make your muscles strong, go to the refrigerator, move it from one room to another room. I have to start on something simple. So in the course of Vipassana, what we are doing, we are taking very simple movement in the body, okay, and things to concentrate and to pay attention, and we are developing the mindfulness slowly, slowly.
And
if it's difficult, if it's complicated, it will not work.
Mm-hmm.
You have many techniques. Even the Buddha, he teach many, many ways. Some monks, they come to the Buddha, they ask, what to do? The Buddha say, you take this exercise, you go to the jungle, you stay there under the umbrella and mosquito net. But some monks, they come to the Buddha, they ask the Buddha, what should I do? The Buddha say, when you are walking, just walk. When you are sitting, just sit. And when you are eating, just eat. Very simple. So different people, they have different training, let's say. Maybe any one of you already hear about other teachers that teach also Vipassana. You don't get confused. It's also Vipassana. If they teach mindfulness, they teach also Vipassana. But maybe different techniques. But it don't mean one is better than other. Huh? It don't mean that I'm going to teach you the best Vipassana. It's another kind of technique. And I study the technique what I'm teaching, or what I learn is from my teacher. I think Maria already talked about this a little bit. About my teacher is from north of Thailand.
Mm-hmm.
My teacher's name is Ajahn Tong.
Mm-hmm.
Ajahn is mean teacher, okay, in Thai language, and Tong is just his name. Yeah. In this case, Tong is gold.
Mm-hmm.
Goldy, I don't know. But it's just his name. Yeah. And then today is about 87 years, he's still teaching. And Ajahn, he took the technique, he built the technique by 3 actions.
Yeah.
He take 3 different elements from the Thai tradition and he used them for building the mindfulness. The first exercise is coming to train how can we be mindful about our end.
Yeah.
We call it mindful posture. Yeah, I think most of you know, you will see this exercise, it will be familiar for you.
Right.
So in India they use it.
Yeah.
Second is coming to train how we can walk with mindfulness.
Mm-hmm.
And we call it walking meditation.
Yeah.
Usually people think meditation is only sitting, but no, meditation, if we talk about Vipassana, every position of body we should be mindful. So we have mindful prostration, we have walking meditation, and then we have also sitting meditation.
Okay.
So maybe if you want, we can try to see how, because I'm very happy, many people today. So we see how, maybe we can do shortly also walking. We see how, we try. Okay? But I teach you first the mindful prostration, the first exercise, and then we can do it together. Okay?
Whatever. You speak.
Yeah. What I speak? I will explain. You speak, huh? So what we do, we sit in this. You can come close. Please, you can come also. No? It's okay? Anyway, what we are doing, we are sitting like this, okay? Yeah, we put the hands on the legs, okay? We are keeping the eyes open, we don't close the eyes. Now, you think tomorrow you are going to turn the wheels of the car, or move the gear, or you are going to write something, to type computer, or eating? You see, you're doing so many things in your hand. How can you be mindful for this complicated movement? So we make small movements, simple movements. But when I'm driving, I don't close my eyes. Okay? When I'm riding, I don't close my eyes. Also here, no reason to close the eyes. Very important. We are going to learn or to build mindfulness, not concentration. Later I will explain you the difference. Okay? If I will not, please ask me what is the difference. Okay? For sure the concentration is building by itself. It will develop by itself. So we are looking at our hands. And then we try to, that everybody will do the same, okay? So we start with the right hand and then we'll continue with the left. Please, you can first look, okay, at Mechimano, and after this I will explain you also. And after this we make it together. There is no, in Vipassana there is no spiritual or energy or things like this. We just do things to build mindfulness. We start with the right hand, not because right hand is special energy or something, just because everybody will do the same. No magic. Okay, so please.
Sitzen, sitzen, sitzen. Drehen, drehen, drehen.
You see, every movement that we are doing, we labeling. Okay, we can label inside by heart, we can label loud, okay? But very important, the movement of the hand and the speech synchronize, starting together. When I start the movement, I start to talk. When I stop, I talk. Drehen, 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 okay?
Drehen, drehen, drehen.
And then we make pause, and then start in next section.
Heben, heben, heben.
The thumbs about 1 inch from the middle of the chest. Okay?
Berühren, berühren, berühren.
The thumbs touching the middle of the chest.
Drehen, drehen, drehen. Heben, heben, heben. Berühren, berühren, berühren.
Now two hands touching each other and the thumbs touching the middle of the chest.
Heben, heben, heben.
We come till the thumb is about 1 inch from the third eye.
Berühren, berühren, berühren. Senken, senken, senken. Berühren, berühren, berühren. Beugen, beugen, beugen.
We go about 45 degrees down.
Senken, senken, senken.
We don't touch yet.
Berühren, berühren, berühren. Bedecken, bedecken, bedecken. Senken, senken, senken. Berühren, berühren, berühren. Bedecken, bedecken, bedecken.
Yeah. The two thumbs touching each other and the finger is parallel.
Beugen, beugen, beugen.
Not touching yet.
Berühren, berühren, berühren.
The thumbs touching the middle of the third eye.
Heben, heben, heben.
Till the arms come to be straight.
Drehen, drehen, drehen. Heben, heben, heben. Berühren, berühren, berühren. Drehen, drehen, drehen. Heben, heben,
we raise up
heben.
The hand and the body together.
Berühren, berühren, berühren.
This was one time of bending to the floor, okay? This exercise of bending to the floor, we are doing 3 times. And after we finish 3 times, we come back to the legs. Okay. So this is all the exercise. Actually very simple. You start like this, go up here, 3 times. Bending to the floor and then come back to the legs. The legs back. Would you like to try together? Please. Good. This is the first exercise. Now we are going to make training for walking. Okay? So very simple, you don't need to be any special movement or whatever. If you want to relax your legs a little bit, and then just when you come to stand up, acknowledge standing, standing, standing. You move with mindfulness, okay? Now I show you the walking, very very simple movement, okay? I start with this, that my hand, right hand is holding the left hand, back of the, from my back, huh? And then the eyes also here, my eyes open, I don't close the eyes. Yeah. And I know what I'm doing, I'm standing, so I know, standing, standing, standing. Now I'm making very simple movement, okay? Yeah, for the start, stehen, stehen, stehen. And then, rest, nach, vorn. Links, nach, vorn. If I don't make big movement, it's enough, even 1.5-2 meters. And then I want to stop, I make rest. Now, four, and then stop, stop, stop. Stay, stay, stay. Now I'm coming to turn. Drehen, 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 drehen. And again, stay, 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 and I continue. Rest, now, four. Link, now, okay? Now, this exercise we make something like 10 minutes for beginners, okay? And then, but now we don't make 10 minutes, we make only 5 minutes. We see how we make some, maybe on the way that everybody can stand up. Just to explain you one more thing, suppose in the middle of the way I'm doing this, now four. And then suddenly, oh, very difficult, there are three, rest, now, falling, or maybe rest, now, falling, links, now, falling, and start to think about, this is a very nice movie. It's in the monkey jumping. I can jump to one of six sense doors. Either I see something, I hear something, I smell something, I taste, hearing, seeing, smelling, tasting, feeling, and thinking. Yeah. So I say that I'm coming to be mindful whatever coming to me, okay? Whatever happened to me. So if during the walking rest, nap on, knees, nap on, I start to think about something. So in this moment, it means my mind is not with the legs, it's my mind is thinking. So in this moment, I be mindful about what happened to me. So first, in the computer, I push reset. Okay? Stop. Then what happened to me? Where my mind jumped? I was thinking something? It means thinking coming on me. Thinking, thinking, thinking. If I see something, doesn't matter what, I see a beautiful picture, I see a beautiful tree, or whatever. Stop, stop, stop. Think, think, think.
And
I hear something, I'm hearing, hearing. We don't acknowledge the objects, we acknowledge the sense doors, okay? I don't acknowledge picture, I acknowledge seeing, okay? Okay? So let's, maybe we can stand in a way that everybody can make walk and turn and come back, okay? Like this line. I know because sometimes in the temple we are even 100 people or more, we are practicing. And no problem.
We go this way?
It's okay, we can go like this. Okay.